Oh, hello and welcome back, people, to Let's Play Harry Potter 3 on the PlayStation. Well, no, it's not for the PlayStation, it's for the original Xbox. The PlayStation version is coming later. It's gonna be in Polish, it's gonna be horrible. And that's why I'm gonna be covering it. Well, not covering, I'll just make a long play of it, because, well, everything that I say about this version pretty much applies to that one as well. And here is one of my favorite puzzles in the game. I'm not exactly sure if this is the way you're intended to solve this, but this is the way I choose to think that it is intended to be solved.
Which makes it the correct way.
Which makes it the more appropriate way. But yeah, we can't quite do it yet. First, we need to initiate this thingamajig. For which we need a Ron.
A singular Ron.
It's just one of them. And Hermione just committed suicide.
As she does.
Oh.
Too much lotion.
Well, I mean, Hermione is indestructible, as we all know. She's a girl, after all. And she has lotion.
Of course. Yes.
I mean, I'm not even joking. Hermione is indestructible. It will become more apparent during the boss of this level.
Is the boss the basilisk?
No. Although Hermione probably just could stare him off to death.
Of course.
So now, That eyeball rained tears on top of that thing, and we can create a block under it. I said we can create a block under it, yes. And now we have to push this, but now see, the way this thing is, you can't really stop it so it would actually shine into the eye.
Oh, I see what you're gonna do.
Unless you have a paperweight hanging around with you. I'm actually pretty sure you're just supposed to make, like, another block for this to work. But a Ron works just as well. You just need to align him properly to stand right there.
Hear him getting hit. Poor Ron.
No, he's fine. He faced through it. Like a champ. But yeah, I'm pretty sure
then
you're
even
supposed
to get the uproaring music about it.
I mean, I stop an ice block on a Ron. I think that calls for some fanfare. See, you ain't getting any roadblock. But yeah, I'm pretty sure that you're just supposed to shine into that eye one more time after you push it to create another block to stop it, like, somewhere in the tracks, but this way's more fun.
Yes, it is. Far more amusing.
And appropriate, considering Ron's role in all of these games. I mean, it could only be more appropriate if he went to sleep afterwards.
Or he was asleep while you were pushing it at him.
Yes. Hermione, would you get here and bap this thing?
Eh. Poor Ron's low on health.
He'll be fine. They may have done this whole tutorial about, like, you know, help your friends when they're down. Leave your friends when they're down. They're going to come back to life on their own. I know this sounds horrible,
but leave
your
friends to die. It's the humane.
No, leave your friends when they die. They'll come back.
A great lesson for kids.
Mm-hmm. But yeah, now we saved Harry from that thing.
Staring at a wall.
And now we have to call him. He's going to get here eventually.
Someday.
Because they did specifically design this dungeon with as little loading screens as possible, so you can't just rearrange people, you know, recall everybody just by going into a door nearby.
Right.
Which is both smart, and also shows a lot of dedication when it comes to optimizing this entire area, because it is quite big.
Oh yeah.
Like, I mean, this is still the exact same room as that pool that Hermione had to cross by freezing the entire lake.
Right.
But yeah, here I was like, there's no way Harry can jump that. Oh wait, he has those...
Ah, but you forget. He was from the PS1 game.
He has those PlayStation 1 roots of absolutely bonkers physics in jumping. He can do it. He can do it if he believes enough. He needs to get a really long running start for it, though.
And specifically bumping around on the way.
Mm-hmm. And staring at this thing.
What is he staring at?
Yeah, they do this eternal darkness thing of looking at things that aren't really important. But no, what they were actually staring at was this device that you can't see regardless of what camera angle you use. Oh, and also, like, when you're watching these videos, you may kind of wonder, why don't I put the game audio any lower? Because, like, sometimes when there is a fight, it's actually kind of hard it kind of overpowers the commentary. I mostly do that because this game has terrible audio mixing for the music, and it's barely audible unless I said it this way, and the music's very good, and I want it to be hearable, because I get copyrights on every single video, and this texture, yeah, there we go.
That was interesting.
Oh, speaking of the music...
It was like freaking Odyssey to the West up in here.
Yeah, speaking of the music, this track is actually the same as the one they used in the second game once you defeat the Basilisk on the... on every system, actually.
Got it! The Carpe Retractum Spellbook!
The Hedwig Bookstand. And now, here I get extremely confused, because they throw a whole bunch of enemies that have, like, a Carpe Retractum shields on them. But here's the thing, you're not actually supposed to... you're not actually supposed to do this unless there are other people around you, because holding onto those shields, you can't really do much. And you can't actually take off their shields, which is what you may think to do, but no, you can't. You're actually first supposed to get to these guys.
Aha. Uh-huh.
And the other ones...
And they probably shouldn't have given you the tutorial message so soon.
Well, no, you're supposed to use it in order to get out of this location, but like... Now here is the thing, they do that for pretty much every single unique spell for each character. They introduce its combat ability in the place where it really does not work, because this game's combat is designed around the idea that you have two doofuses just sort of prancing around you and sometimes casting Flipendo, right? Now, every time you get a spell, well, I mean, they make sure that you only get it with the character that is supposed to get it, by separating them. But they immediately want to teach you the combat use of that particular spell, but it really does not work unless you have those doofuses on you. So here, I am desperately trying to actually, you know, like, use it to get rid of the shields. No, you're just supposed to use Flipendo. They will sometimes block, but most of the times they won't. And now, when it comes to this, you're always supposed to stand like damn near fucking edge of the platform in order to actually be able to use this. And well, it's decent-ish for the most part. There's one place where I just choose to you'll see. It definitely has too short of a it has too short of a range on its auto lock on. Yeah, like there.
Right.
So okay, I already arranged this not because I planned ahead, but because I was desperately trying to do something. And there aren't any more enemies, thankfully. And that thing didn't come to life. That's good because Hermione is not around with her lotion powers.
God.
Now, this is actually something I really like, because these two doofuses can't get over here because they can't Potter jump.
Right.
So you actually need to like pull one, get to the other side, and pull the other, and only you can do it, which is a really nice use of like, you know, character specific abilities.
Mm-hmm. Anytime, Hermione.
This is what we think about you.
Rejected.
Yeah, I'm trying to aim for this or like do something about that grade, but I just can't. And this is gonna be like the one case of them actually giving you a useful hint. Eventually.
I already know what you have to do.
Like, here's the thing, you can't aim for that.
Mm-hmm.
Harry?
Didn't we just exit the way we came? Eh.
And now you can aim for it. Or maybe it just did not click in for whatever reason, but I swear I tried.
Right. Only Hermione can crawl. We've established mm-hmm. this.
Yes. It is the lotion that that she uses in order to lubricate herself, in order to pass through.
So she pours it all over her body.
Yes.
And not just her hands.
Mm-hmm. Unlimited lotion abilities.
And also using her magic, she can use the lotion all over her body and clothes to create bubbles to fight with.
Yes.
Please tell me there's a bubble spell in this game and Hermione gets it.
In the fourth game there is a bubble spell.
You know what? Good enough.
I mean, we're lucky there even is one. But yeah, this time I can pull the shield off. And it works just like every other clusterfuck fight in this game.
Yeah, this whole game's battle system is a cluster.
It is, but at least it's easy. You know? It's not the kind of clusterfuck where you get killed over and over. I guess one of them just got killed like that.
Dynasty Warriors Potter, anybody? Am I right?
Potter Musso. you know people
warriors.
Would... Yes. Hogward Warriors.
I mean, I'd play it.
I would be scared of that thing, too. But yeah, this is...
Got a cloak made of shields.
Mm-hmm. No, this boss isn't actually difficult
nice
or
anything. Nice shot there,
but then it does this.
Oh god, that's horrifying.
It is,
Jesus.
The boss fight still isn't like any difficult, but at least it's more interesting when they do that.
Yeah.
And also, how the
Seriously,
hell did they?
What the hell?
How the hell did they even fit there? Right?
No idea.
Oh no, you don't need any help, Hermione. You'll be fine.
You're unkillable. It's okay.
Yeah, you'll see that. But yeah, it seems like the best way of dealing with them is to let one of your friends get hurt by them, and then they will be like, I did a function.
Yeah. I like that Ron just casually walks away from all this, though. He's like, yeah, whatever.
See, Hermione's dead, but she's fine.
She'll be okay.
See, she has no health, but she still goes on. And also there is...
she never gives up.
Uh-oh. Also, there is something very odd about spells in this place. As you will notice, whenever Hermione casts something, one of them just sort of shoots off in a random direction every single time.
Yeah, I've noticed. It's Gilgamesh! I can't believe Harry Potter and Final Fantasy crossed over.
Hmm. You mean that ROM hack that's so much better than the original?
Oh yeah, totally.
That was anticlimactic.
Just pull its head off, whatever.
I mean, admittedly, it only had so much health, but I expected that face to be, I don't know, a bit more. But, you know, pacing. Who needs it?
Yeah.
50 house points for Gryffindor. Class dismissed.
We could go looking for potions ingredients. That new spell might come in handy. But then again, we could all turn in. What do you think?
Oh, I don't know. I'm worn out. But we have to get off this floor, because those prefects will start doing their rounds in a few minutes.
Well, you know, we can all...
You've got to keep out of the way!
Stupid books. Can't even steal from the teachers.
I know, right? How rude.
How inconsiderate.
It's getting late.
Also, what? Oh wait, Hogwarts. I was about to say, what kind of teacher just puts a bunch of monsters in their freaking classroom?
And then a monster book. A book of monsters. Thankfully, it's, you know, this was the first enemy in the game, so it's not difficult at all. And it's dead.
Now we can steal.
Good.
You've killed me! Good.
Faces of evil.
You should totally edit that in. Just the you good. Killed me scene, and then Harry just going, good!
Oh, great.
Oh my god, so many beans.
Most of them are actually in the box. But you can do this.
Right.
Glad they thought of that. Now that we have Carpere Tractum, we can use this to, interact with certain things we couldn't before. Like, for example, this thing. See how happy Ron was about
Ron
it?
Ron was flipping out. He was like, oh, look, book monsters. Yay.
And they're... I think they re-missed their old book space.
I'm not sure that there's much to do right.
Right.
That's why they're so angry.
Hermione, do you not see the book monster right in front of you?
I think they are specifically programmed to just not interact with the book monsters, so you can turn them into mice for various reasons. But yeah, this is it for now. I was just reading the textures. Because they actually did put a lot of effort into those. Even though there is like maybe three of them.